what I found out, and it ain't no need to cry. I took a vow that from now on I'm gonna be my own best friend. Me, myself, and I, that's all I got.
Me. It's what about me? It's all about me. And we all knew this one. And we definitely know this one. Movement. It's everywhere. It's on television, it's all over social media, it's in my actions, it's in your actions, and it's in the actions of others. In the last video blog, I shared with you how I was having an affair with things that took my focus off of my relationship with Christ. I would have never had that affair had I not been in such a selfish place in my life, had I not been had such a selfish mindset. When I say selfish, I'm referring to lowercase selfish. I'm referring to how we always want to make sure that we're straight, that we have everything we need. And in the process, at times, we may be isolating, alienating, or ignoring the feelings of other people or the wants and needs of other people. We're not taking them into consideration. When I started my discipleship program, one of the first things that we learned about was the ministry of nurturing. And that's what we need to do when we're taking others into consideration and move from the selfish to the selfish. And I'll be getting to all caps selfish. But before I move on, I want to share with you a scripture that I learned. It's John 13:34-35. A new command I give to you, that you love one another as I have loved you, that you also love one another. By this, all will know that you're my disciples, because you will have love for one another. That's God's word, which is the truth. When we're showing love for one another, we're stepping outside of our old selfish ways, that lowercase selfish, to the uppercase selfish. I opened this video blog with Beyoncé's Me, Myself, and I. That song was so fitting to me because I was in a place of me, myself, and I. I only thought about me. I wasn't taking anyone else into consideration, the thoughts and needs and wants of others. And as I shared through my discipleship program, I learned how to effectively do this so it would honor God. So I went from a me, myself, and I to a me, myself, and Christ. When I'm keeping him included in what I'm doing so he can lead me, my selfish ways go from the lowercase selfish to the uppercase selfish. And that is me, myself, and ish incessantly serving him. When I'm incessantly serving him, then I'm honoring him through my actions, my thoughts, my words, and the way that I serve and treat others. It says in God's word, in Philippians 2:3-4.
Do nothing from rivalry or conceit, but in humility count others more significant than yourselves. Let each of you look not only to his own interests, but also to the interests of others.
I really love that scripture because it speaks to how you need to humble yourself and be of service to others and be more attentive to their interests, their needs, their wants. In this journey, I just wanted to do better in my life. I wanted to be better in my life. I wanted to honor God, but also honor other people. And the only way I could do that was not only to get closer in his word, but to spend more time with him. So that's another level to being selfish. You know, I was selfish with my time with other people. I was, you know, always doing me and didn't have time in those things. But I was also being selfish with my time for Christ. So now I'm in a place of, yes, I'm selfish with my time for him because I'm giving him time. I'm cutting out other things, distractions, and things like that that take me away from him. And I spend that quiet time with him so I can get in tune with him, so he can use me. And so I can not only honor him through how I treat others, but I can honor him through my service to all. I want to leave you with this. If you don't check how you're being or how you're treating others, trust me, God will check you. I invite you to connect with the conversation below. Be transparent and get free. I look forward to blogging with you below on TaraGateSanderson.com.